Thank you. Tonight, questions about a possible connection to the worst day in American history. Did an admitted con man turned informant tip authorities, including a state senator and a U.S. senator, to a threat against the World Trade Center? News Channel 5's Kathleen Walter is joining us with the results of a News Channel 5 investigation tonight. Kathleen.
Well, Jim, Randy Glass is a man with a criminal past, but someone the government trusted enough with very sensitive and classified intelligence information. There is no dispute he was wired into international arms dealers and may have heard about terrorist threats to the United States. What did a local and U.S. senator from Florida do with the information he says he passed along?
Seemed the unthinkable, terrorists using airplanes as deadly weapons to attack the Pentagon and the World Trade Center. But to Randy Glass, the idea that terrorists wanted to bring down the Twin Towers came as no surprise to him.
I felt incredibly uncomfortable because I knew that something was going to happen.
For more than 2 years, Glass was caught up in an international arms deal. An admitted con man living in Boca Raton, Florida, Glass put his skills to work for the government. An informant to the FBI and Florida's Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms, Glass and other agents posed as illegal arms dealers, hawking arms purportedly diverted from U.S. military armories and luring in prospective weapons buyers who might have been linked to terrorism. His life as a secret agent was chronicled on tape.
What would you do?
I'd kill him. I'll kill you.
Through accused middleman Diamoyshan, Glass was introduced to weapons buyers who said they had connections to Islamic militant groups with possible links to Osama bin Laden.
You know who supplies him with money?
Who?
Yeah.
That's very nice.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for mentioning that.
Americans were the enemy, and that the purpose of obtaining these weapon systems and nuclear materials was to use against Americans.
And Glass says threats against Americans didn't end there.
I did know that there was a plan of attack on the United States, and the World Trade Center had been mentioned.
But in the summer of 2001, Glass's undercover work came to an end. 3 months before September 11th, he reached out to Florida State Senator Ron Klein and told him about threats against national security. Klein says he doesn't recall any mention of World Trade Center threats.
This is before September 11th and all that. Again, it was enough information for me to say, I don't know exactly what to do with this other than to contact one of my federal colleagues.
And so State Senator Ron Klein contacted the office of Florida Senator Bob Graham, the chair of the Senate Intelligence Committee.
According to a Graham spokesperson, Jill Greenberg, caseworker Charlie Aunt spoke with Glass last summer prior to September 11th, Glass claiming he had at least 6 conversations with the caseworker. And while we've been unable to corroborate the nature of those conversations, Greenberg confirms some of that information was passed along to the Senate Intelligence Committee.
A few months before September 11th, your office received information from ATF informant Randy Glass, who also worked on the terrorism task force, and he also advised your office of terrorist intentions to bring down the World Trade Center. And this was before September 11th. Your office tells me it forwarded information from Mr. Glass to the Intelligence Committee. And my question is, why did no one from the committee follow up with Mr. Glass to pursue this?
Well, because we, in turn, gave that information to the appropriate intelligence agency. We are an oversight and legislative agency. The actual operations of collection of information, interviewing possible sources, is the responsibility of the FBI if it's a domestic matter, or the CIA if it's foreign.
And according to State Senator Klein, 3 weeks after he made initial contact with Senator Graham's office in the summer of 2001, staffers there confirmed to him Glass's information had been passed on to the intelligence community.
They confirmed to you that they'd sent it along.
Mm-hmm. They said to me that they had spoken, they had processed it through their office, and spoken to Randy, I believe is what they said, and they had processed it.
I had a concern about that and a dozen other pieces of information which were emanating in the summer of 2001.
So you did forward Mr. Glass's information along to whom?
I cannot say what agency, but the agency that we felt was the most appropriate one for the nature of the information that he was providing.
Despite his keen insight into the world of terrorists, Randy Glass says that until recently, no one from any intelligence agency has contacted him. And since our interview with Senator Graham in Boca Raton last month, his office offered this clarification, that Mr. Glass did not provide any information to our office prior to September 11, 2001, that needed to be pursued by intelligence agencies. When I was interviewed in Boca Raton, I said that I did know of this individual and that he had been in touch with the Intelligence Committee, but I didn't indicate when that contact had taken place. It was earlier this year, not prior to September 11, 2001.
Even though Graham's press aide Jill Greenberg and State Senator Klein say Glass's information did go before the intelligence community prior to September 11, 2001, the senator still maintains that's not the case, even though that's what he initially told us. Jim?
Kathleen, a lot of information to digest, but do we know exactly what information did go to the senator?
Well, at the end of the day, we just don't know. We called Graham staffer Charlie on several times to find out more about his conversations with Mr. Glass, but he did not return our phone calls. We are still investigating and hope to have answers in the coming weeks. Live on the Nightbeat, Kathleen Walter, News Channel 5.